So to figure this out, let's have a look back at our picture from before. So we said that in a set formula, each clause must be satisfied, and said this is kind of similar to the requirement that each city must be visited at least once. So this would suggest to add some additional vertices to the picture that represent clauses. So let's say we have one vertex here that represents clause number one, and another vertex here for clause number two, and so on. So what we could say is that visiting this vertex here represents satisfying that clause. And then, of course, we need to make sure that we can only visit this city here if the corresponding variable, or if one of the corresponding variables of that clause is satisfied in the right way. So what about a construction that looks like this? I connect the vertex that represents the clause to this one here, and I connect it to this vertex here, and I connect it to this vertex here. And what I would like you to think about now is the following. There are 2 to the power of n shortest paths between A and B if we do not regard this vertex here. So if we do not have clause 1, and I realize it's not the best name for that vertex, but that's okay. So if we have to visit this vertex here, so it's now become part of our graph, how many shortest paths from A to B do you have then that visit all vertices? Is it still 2 to the power of n? Is it 2 to the power of n plus 1? Or is it 2 to the power of n minus 1?